Have you ever wanted to launch a paint can into the sky? Well, today I'm going to teach you how with my experiment, Exploding Witches Brew. Hi everyone, I'm Emily Calandrelli, MIT engineer and host of Emily's Wonder Lab. And on my channel, we get to talk about all things space and science. So grab your paint cans and get ready for an explosion. To make your exploding witch's brew, aka paint can rocket, here's what you need. A metal paint can with the lid, 1 cup of baking soda, 1 cup of vinegar, a rubber mallet, and some safety glasses. Eventually, we are going to mix our baking soda and vinegar in our paint can. But first, I want to show you what that's going to look like. So here we have a see-through paint can. We are going to add 1 cup of baking soda into our paint can and 1 cup of vinegar right on top. It's going to sit in a plastic cup and we're going to nestle it into the baking soda. And that's going to stay that way while we hammer on our lid really good and tight. You want a tight seal. And then eventually we are going to flip over our paint can and the baking soda and the vinegar are going to mix together. That kickstarts an acid-base chemical reaction that creates carbon dioxide bubbles. Let's see what that looks like. Ooh, whoa, 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 whoa. Okay, see all of those carbon dioxide bubbles building and building and building and building. Now, just imagine what would happen if the lid were on nice and tight. What do you think would happen to this paint can? Let's see it in action. Now we are going to make our paint can rocket, aka our exploding witch's brew. So get your paint can, set it down on a flat surface. Parents and adults, let's do this one outside. And because we are dealing with exploding paint cans, we need to exercise caution here. Go ahead and put 1 cup of baking soda in the bottom of your paint can. 1, 2, 3. Shake it around so it's flat. Now we're going to add 1 cup of vinegar to a plastic cup. Now very carefully, so that they do not mix, place it gently on top of your baking soda. And the way that I do this is I sort of circle it around, creating a little bowl in the middle so that it holds on to that cup right there and it won't fall over. There we go. Now for the exciting part. It's at this point where you need to put on your safety goggles, like this. Now get your lid and we are going to hammer this on nice and tight. So I like to do a star formation where I just hit this in the pattern of a star. One error that you might make is not putting this on as tight as you should. You really want to create a perfect seal because if you don't, those air bubbles are going to escape and your rocket's not going to launch. Okay, let me check. All right, guys, our paint can is ready to go. In fact, it's ready to blow. Are you ready to flip it over? Are we? Yeah, you were ready? Okay, here we go. Paint can launching in 3, 2, 1. What? And that is a paint can rocket. Okay, we are going to make another paint can rocket, but this time we're going to do things a little differently. I'm going to use half of the baking soda and half of the vinegar to see if that changes anything. I'm trying to make my paint can go even higher. We'll see if that makes a difference. So I have my baking soda in here. I have my vinegar in here. I'm just going to nestle it right in the middle there. Put my lid on, hammer it down well.
My hypothesis is that more baking soda and vinegar makes a more violent reaction, kicking off the lid too early. Maybe with fewer materials, we can get more air, more fuel to slowly build up before it launches.
I think that's good to go. One more for good measure. All right, launching paint can number 2 in 3, 2, 1. Whoa. And that is a paint can rocket. So what made our paint can rocket launch? Well, that acid-base chemical reaction inside made those carbon dioxide bubbles. And those bubbles were building and building and building. And so the pressure inside your paint can was also building and building and building until the lid couldn't take the pressure anymore and it popped off, sending all of that air rushing downwards. And because of Newton's third law of motion, for every action, there's an equal and opposite reaction, our paint can went upwards. Thank you for making a paint can rocket with me. If you like this one, be sure to check out my best-selling Stay Curious and Keep Exploring book series for 99 more science experiments. I'm Emily Calandrelli. Subscribe for all things science and space. And remember, stay curious, and keep exploring. I'll see you next time. Emily's Science Lab.